Greetings, everybody. It is the Doctor. Welcome back to our Let's Play of Star Trek Online on the Federation side in 2015. In this video, I am going to do the complete, and I mean complete, tutorial of Star Trek Online. Now, I know that this tutorial is quite long, so expect this video to be kind of lengthy. If you guys wouldn't mind for me, drop a line in the comments and let me know what you think of the volume. My voice versus the game volume, etc. I want to make sure you guys can hear this well. Not just the game, obviously me, but the game as well, the dialogue in the game, all the sound effects. As for the music...
People you can interact with have icons above their heads. You can press the interaction key, default F, to talk with them.
So default F is to talk to people with icons over their heads. Keep that in mind. I've turned the music down in the game. It is still on, but it's very low, hoping we won't get any claims there on the music. That is often an issue in YouTube, but I wish I could have the music on full blast for you guys, but that also gets in the way sometimes of the dialogue and sound effects and so forth. Okay, that aside, let's get on with the tutorial. We need to talk to Eliza Flores, who is this person in front of us. And I think you have a very similar haircut to my own. Hello, kindred spirit. Talk to Cadet Flores.
Finally, I was beginning to think you forgot what today was.
How could I? You've reminded me every day for the past month. Did you get your assignment?
Of course, I was first in line. Oh, before I forget, I think Rasky is just ahead. He wanted to thank you for helping him cram for the astrometrics final.
Okay, now I need to talk to another person, Cadet Rasky. Obviously, this is just helping you to understand the game mechanics and how the game itself works. Talking to people, interacting with people, finding out how to walk and move, and using your waypoints to figure out where to go.
There you are! I wanted to thank you for helping me pass that final, and for all the other times you've helped me. I've always admired you. I hope Starfleet recognizes all you've done to lead our class.
Why,
what ship
you.
Did you get?
What kind of person are you? Thank you for admiring me. Well, I haven't received my assignment yet. I am just but a cadet.
Good luck. Before you report to Lieutenant Farah and get your assignment, you should find Tevrel. She wanted to talk to you. She's just up the pathway.
Now I have to find somebody else, Tevrel, up the pathway. By the way, I will be reading all the dialogue in Star Trek Online. We're going to go through all the dialogue. I'm going to listen to it. I'm going to read it. We are going to get down and dirty in this storyline. Down and dirty.
Greetings.
Rosky said you had something to tell me.
It was good of you to encourage me to retake the linguistics final. I was willing to accept my original results, but you saw that I was not at my best that day. My score increased by 12.8% on the second attempt, well within my standard norms. Now I am qualified to serve as both a science officer and a communications officer.
Awesome.
Morik would like to see you as well. He is ahead of us on the path. Live long and prosper.
So these must
your
be
mini-map
my
Your mini-map shows
classmates.
You where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the mini-map if you are far away from your objective.
So these must all be my classmates who have come to talk to me. And I am wearing a cadet uniform, I just noticed, so I'm not wearing the uniform I thought I would be wearing. As I put it on at the beginning, you'll notice the game has auto-put on me, auto-selected, a cadet uniform. I like that. That's a good touch because I wasn't going to go spend the Zen to do it, so it shows I'm a cadet. That is really cool. So obviously it's telling us here how to use the waypoints and find places on the map. Of course, I already know all that, but it's good for new players. Teaches them how to use the maps.
There you are! Getting excited yet? Once we finish our training cruise, we'll all be full-fledged ensigns. The buzz is, Captain Taggart hasn't named all of his senior staff yet. From what I heard, the advanced phaser training simulation is tripping people up.
Oh, the advanced phaser training simulation is tripping people up, really? Okay, I need to get my training assignment from Lieutenant Farah. I got a comment in the last video, and I want to thank the person for reminding me of this. My ship name, I chose Andromeda, but maybe I should have chose something different, like, let's say, Moya. That's right. Also a Farscape fan. Huge, huge Farscape fan. How could I forget that show? I should have incorporated it somehow. The antics of John Crichton are just crazy. I love it. Anyway, yeah, maybe I should have named my ship Moya. Wouldn't that have been cool? All right. Talk to Lieutenant Farah.
Good afternoon, Cadet. What can I do for you?
Well, is this where I get my training cruise assignment?
Yes. I have the complete assignment list here. Name?
I'll be Rami Summers.
Let's see. Interesting. Report to Captain Taggart. He's in the office behind me.
Is there a problem, Mr. Kitty Cat?
You're going to have to ask him.
It is the kitty cat. Hello,
the direction of your objectives also appears on your compass.
Come.
Okay, that was rather different. He's like, come. But very short, to the point.
Cadet.
You asked to see me, sir?
I did. I've been following your progress here at the Academy, and I must say, I'm impressed.
Why, thank you, Captain.
I'm just looking at your final test scores, but I don't see your results for the Advanced Phaser Training Program.
Okay, well, I can say a couple of things here. This is where we start getting into different dialogue options. I love it. All right, I know what program is advised for Tactical Officer, but I thought I had more time to take it, or many of my classmates didn't take the test either. Okay, well, first of all, I'm not the kind of person, at least this character is not the kind of person, that would throw somebody under the bus, especially my classmates. So let's blame this. This is a me problem, not a classmate problem. All right, I know that program is advised for tactical officers, but I thought I had more time to take it.
I want everyone on my senior staff to run that program, and I want to see good results, no exceptions.
Ooh, did you say senior staff? Wait a minute.
I did. Like I said, I've been following your career here at the Academy. If you complete that program, I can put you on my bridge. Oh. I'll ask my tactical officer to set it up.
Oh, your tactical officer? Who is that?
Another fine cadet like yourself. Her scores were almost as good as yours, but her record has a few blemishes. Still, I'm sure Cadet Flores will settle down and become a fine officer someday.
I like the fact that it kind of recognizes I'm a tactical officer. This is good. These are good things.
I'll tell Flores to meet you out in the quad. Talk to her to start the phaser training, and I'll see you when you're finished. You're dismissed, Cadet.
Great. Yeah, I like the fact it knows I'm a tactical officer. Following that career path, need to do things that are tactically oriented. Okay, we gotta go find Flores. She's over here now.
I got the tactical officer spot. Just what I wanted. Where'd you end up?
Well, guess what? Me and you are going for the same spot, I guess. Captain Taggart says he wants me on the senior staff, but I have to pass advanced phaser training first.
You never did that? I thought you were Miss Extra Credit.
Yeah,
everyone
knows
that Captain Taggart expects all his top people to pass that program.
Now you tell me.
Don't worry, you'll do fine. Come on, I'll take you to the holodeck and set it up.
Lead the way, please.
Seems most of our class ended up on Captain Taggart's ship.
Funny how that works, huh?
Have you seen the whales in San Francisco Bay? I never seem to spot them.
Why, neither do I. I do wonder what happens to those
whales. I sometimes forget that Boothby is a hologram. He seems like such a fixture here at Starfleet Academy.
Seriously,
to sprint,
what happened?
Tap the shift key while moving.
Last one of the console buys the first round tonight.
What happened to George and Gracie? Somebody tell me. Did they have offspring? Did they die? Did they? Did anybody ever take care of them after that episode or after that movie? All right, talk to Cadet Flores.
Setting up the training program now. I hope Holodeck 2 is your lucky holodeck.
Have any advice for me? I want to pass this.
Shoot stuff, don't die. Pretty basic, really.
What kind of tactics can I expect?
It's standard stuff. The program runs a variation on Mako assault training.
You're setting up the program. Are you making it easy for me?
The last time I tried to give someone a little help, I ended up on academic probation for the rest of the year. Not saying I haven't learned a few tricks since then, though.
So are you saying that you're helping me right now? I'll need a phaser.
Phasers are in the lockers by the holodecks. You can grab one there.
Press the V key to scan the area. Your tricorder will point you toward your nearest objective.
Eliza, you having a problem going through the door? I recommend going through the part that doesn't have glass. Good job. We can go through doors. I do wish they had done more with this area. It's such a nice area they built here, the Academy. But there aren't really any missions that have anything to do with the Academy. Except for the tutorial here.
The pistol has been automatically equipped.
Yippee-ki-yay. I got a pistol. I'm gonna shoot. I can't shoot.
Move to the center of the room.
By your command. Begin program. Whoa, I'm on a Klingon ship.
In combat, right click on a target.
Got it. Kill. Destroy. All too easy.
While in combat, certain actions are disabled. Once you drop out of combat, more detail about ground combat will become available.
Why, thank you. So I'm in red alert. Here we go. Exit simulation. That was it. Well, that was easy.
You can holster and draw your weapon with the H key.
H. Talk to Captain Taggart.
Well done, cadet. You're not going to break the Academy record, but your score was more than satisfactory.
I thought I did pretty good there.
Absolutely. I have a new first officer. Congratulations.
First officer?
Yes. You should be proud of your accomplishments here, cadet. You have a promising career ahead of you in Starfleet.
I find that decision a little curious, straight from cadet to first officer. Is that really how things work?
First officer, way to go! Just a little jealous, I'll admit. At least now you'll get to boss us all around like you've always wanted.
I'm a bit of a humble person. Remember, I'm a small town girl. So I'm not going to say, what can I say? The captain sees greatness in me, or I think you should just start referring to me as sir. I'm not mean. No, it's a lot of pressure. I hope I'm up for it.
You'll do great. But we should head up to the shuttle bay. Everyone else is waiting there for the ceremonial send-off toast.
The direction of your objectives also appears on your compass.
The shuttle bay, huh?
Now hear this. All cadets report to shuttle bay to prepare for departure.
Nice. Turbolift to shuttle bay, please.
Okay, all of the senior staff is waiting by the bar. I'm sure everyone's a bit nervous, this being our first real assignment and all. So, I'm expecting an inspiring speech out of you. Something heartwarming. Make Tavrell cry. This mission could just determine the rest of our careers. No pressure. I'll meet you over there.
Make a toast to the rest of the senior staff. But I don't want to make toast. I want pancakes. Well, I like how they're all, like, lined up and ready for a toast. okay. This is cool. I can inspire the cadets, I can intimidate the cadets, or I can just be humble. What did I say right before this? I said I was humble. I kind of wanted to do inspire, but no, I don't think I've ever done the be humble option before. So let's try it. On the first day of class 4 years ago, I looked in the mirror and thought, there is no way I can do this. I know I wasn't the only one. I can embolden, I can intimidate. I like how you can intimidate. Or you can just continue to be humble. I look around this room and see fear and uncertainty in your eyes. Being responsible for so many lives is a heavy burden. I can galvanize the cadets. I can terrorize the cadets. Wouldn't that be fun? Or I can show humility. I am the kind of cadet that really wants to terrorize the cadets. But I'm going to be humility, Eid. All I ask is that we support one another. If we can work as a team, we can accomplish our goals. To Starfleet Academy, to the USS Andromeda, to her crew, raise a glass to the class of 2409.
All cadets, please board your shuttles.
Nice. I'll take it. Chat with Chevrel. My assignment on the ship is that of communications. The captain expects sufficient yet informative... what did she say? On the bridge is what I intend to provide. Expects sufficient communication on the bridge, and that is what I... Okay, good. This is Zarva. My assignment is acting chief of engineering. All these months of studying the Miranda's technical manuals is about to pay off. I'm slotted as security. Not that I expect anything to actually do anything exciting on a training cruise. So you're the one who got first officer. Honestly, I'm kind of relieved. I hear Captain Taggart is a stickler for the results on his bridge. I'm the acting medical officer. If you happen to trip and stub your toe, I'm the Benzite to see. Acting helmsman Ann Potter reporting for duty. Course and speed. So that's everybody's position. That's cool. It's a neat area up here, and I guess we're going to board our shuttle to our ship.
Are you ready to head to the ship?
Let's do it. That was a nice little send-off. So all of us cadets are headed to space.
I can't believe we're finally doing this. Oh, look at that.
Yep.
The USS Vesta, first of her class. She's got subsystem targeting, a crew of 750, auxiliary phaser cannons, and even a quantum field focus controller.
Ooh.
I can't wait to captain one someday.
I want one
but
of those.
Here's our ship.
But here's our
Miranda class, 200 crew, 2 forward weapon mounts, 1 aft, average speed, warp 5.0. She's a tough little ship, though. I think I like her.
I like how they tell you the specs of the ship you're going
to
get.
We're the final shuttle to arrive.
Two
we
forward,
need to get to
aft.
The bridge.
Kind of know what to expect out of it. Alright, I guess we are aboard.
I'm going to check in and then head for the bridge. See you there.
Talk to the duty officer in the shuttle bay. Okay. Where would that be? Over here? Ah.
Name and position?
Cadet Rami Summers, acting first officer.
I have your record right here, sir. Welcome to the ship.
Where is the captain?
Captain Taggart is waiting for you on the bridge. Use the turbo lift behind me. It will take you directly there.
Nice. Enter the turbo lift and go to the bridge. I'm on the bridge. And there's our space dock. Oh my gosh. I like how you can see the outside part of the ship here through the window. That is really cool.
Welcome to the bridge, number one. Early in my career, I served with a captain who called his first officer that. I always liked it. As my number one, I expect you to ensure my orders are carried out, and to advise me on the best course of action in any situation. But first, we need to get out to dry dock, get clearance from control, and close the shuttle bay doors, then disable the tractor moorings.
Okay, Trevrell, get clearance from traffic control for the Andromeda to leave the gantry.
Earth traffic control has cleared us to depart, sir.
Very good, number one.
Flores, send the signal to close the shuttle bay doors.
Shuttle bay doors are closed, sir.
Very good, number one.
Potter, wait for me to disable the tractor moorings. Okay, done. Captain, I have done things.
Potter, take us out. One quarter impulse.
Captain, may I remind you that Starfleet regulations specify thrusters only while in the vicinity of space dock. I've got to do it because I'm trying to do my best and I'm fresh out of the academy. It's something a cadet would say.
Just checking to see if you were paying attention, number one. Potter, take us out. Maximum thrusters.
Ah, so it's a good thing I did this with him. He actually admired that.
To sit, right-click on the chair you wish to sit in.
Okay, sit down. And something happens. There we go. We are leaving Dry Dock in our new Miranda-class ship.
Cleared from Dry Dock, Captain.
Good. Let's start with something easy. Set course for Vulcan.
That's pretty easy.
Course lead in, sir.
Close by. Six light years, I think. So pretty close.
Captain, I am picking up a distress call from the SS Break-Even. Audio only.
Let's hear it, Tavrell.
This is the SS Break-Even. Our warp core is failing, and we are in need of assistance.
Let them know we're on our way. Potter, lay in a rendezvous course.
Altering course, sir. ETA 3 minutes.
Transporter room, prepare to beam over survivors.
Sir, sensors can't read anything in the vicinity of the Break-Even.
Communications are out as well.
Keep trying to hail them, Tavrell. Number one, let's discuss the situation.
In front of everybody? I guess so.
You heard the distress call, number one. What do you think we should do?
Is this a test, sir? Part of the training cruise?
Absolutely not. We're the closest ship to the Break-Even, so it's our duty to assist.
It's strange that the transmission was audio only. A warp core emergency shouldn't affect communications.
Good. What do you advise?
Okay, well, I get to make some choices here for the first time. Let's see. I recommend we go to red alert, full power to weapons, and load photon torpedoes. That might be a bit drastic. Shields up, sir. Better safe than sorry. Or we need more information before we get in there. I recommend scanning for an hour to see exactly what the situation is. Okay. First of all, the first option, that is not exactly... I mean, while that would definitely put us on the defense, that's not the best situation here right now. The bottom one, definitely not an option either. If we wait an hour, their warp core emergency could turn into a warp core breach. No captain would sit on their butt for an hour waiting to do something. Shields up, sir. Better safe than sorry. I think that's the best way to go here.
Raising the shields does seem to be a reasonable precaution.
Could be a trap.
I agree. Flores, raise shields. Number one, get down to the transporter room. You'll oversee the rescue effort from there.
Okay. Take turbolift to transporter room. And, Rurik, the Break-Even should be in range. Give me an update.
I'm getting some weird readings.
Weird, huh?
I can't get a solid lock. There may be interference. Trying to compensate. I think I have it. This is a lot different than the training scenarios. Beaming them over now. Klingons!
This vessel is now property of Captain Kadek of the IKS Chot.
Okay, we got Klingons on board. Klingons, Captain, there's Klingons on the starboard bow. Starboard bow. Shoot to kill.
Stop. Security is reporting disruptive fire in the transporter room, and Klingon transporter signatures are showing up all over the ship. They're boarding us. You have the command codes to unlock an armory near your position. Arm yourself. And any security team members you find.
Get a phaser rifle from the armory. What about the enemy ship, sir?
We still have weapons. I'll do what I can. For now, I need you to concentrate on getting those Klingons off my ship.
Repel the Klingon invasion. Got it. So let's arm up at the armory.
locker in this room and interact with it to get a better weapon.
Get a rifle. I got a phaser rifle. Okay, let's put it on our character.
You can switch between two equipped weapons by pressing Z.
Z. Okay. There's my weapon. No shields or armor, huh? Okay. It says to talk to the security cadet, but where would that person be? At this point, it's not giving me an waypoint. That's weird. Huh. Oh, there it is. Order cadet. You have to get near them. Whoa, Klingons.
An item has dropped for you. Move towards the item and press F to loot it.
Well, I would if not for a cutscene. Okay, moving on in space now.
You have recovered a hypo spray. You can use this to quickly heal any damage you may have suffered.
Why, thank you.
You can do extra damage to enemies by flanking them. Try attacking your enemies on their sides or behind them.
Flank, flank, flank. Flank, 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 flank. I win. Repel Klingon borders 71%.
Some objects can be destroyed and create environmental effects. You can destroy the EPS conduit near the Klingons to damage them.
Oh, like that. Actually shooting it. Talk to Captain Taggart. Wait for plasma. Talk to Captain Taggart. Okay,
number one, we're doing our best to cripple this Klingon marauder, but I need your help. Time to show off that academy training.
Okay, so if I were an engineer, I can improve the ship's structural integrity field. If I were science, I can reinforce the shields. But I am tactical, so I know how to improve the ship's weapons.
Sometimes missions specialized to your career class are available.
Just like that one. So let's go do that then. Weapons bay. I like the sound of weapons bay. Man, I love how easy the enemy is to take down at this level of the game. That's like two shots. They're dead. Takes down half of their health in one shot.
Press C to crouch. Crouching is a defensive bonus against ranged attacks, but increases damage from melee attacks. Press X to aim your weapon. Aiming your weapon gives a bonus to damage.
Nice. Breach the door. Okay, I have breach. Nice. All right. Let's do the weapon thing. Make our ship better. Final one.
Number one, we've got injured up here and the Klingons could send a boarding party at any time. I need you back on the bridge.
Go see to the bridge. We will secure this area.
I like all the torpedoes in here. This is a dangerous room to have a firefight in, actually. Okay, back to the turbo lift. We are going to go to the bridge. We have cleared this area of Klingons. We have bolstered the weapon power. And now we go to the bridge. Ooh, and there's Klingons on board the bridge. Get them off. Get them all off. Go away, Klingon. Flank your butts. I come in here and, like, save the day. I'm the only person left on the bridge, and I come in here. I save the day. Okay, talk to the wounded bridge crew, huh? Or tend to them. I have tended to you.
Incoming transmission from the Klingons.
This is Captain Kadek of the IKS Chot. You may have forced my boarding parties off your decks, but our ship remains cloaked. You have no hope of finding us or defeating us. Your choice is simple. Surrender, or we will kill your captain and then destroy your ship.
Never give up, never surrender.
Perhaps your captain will change your mind.
Captain? Planet.
Order your crew to surrender, Captain, or I will blow them out of the sky.
Oh, he's going to blow us out of the
sky. It's your choice, Captain. Do you want these children to die?
Very well.
Ooh, he gave up easily.
Number one, you are now the captain of the ship. Your orders...
Your orders are to lock onto my combat and fire!
Pegatoza!
Oh, he's gonna stab him. Oh, he did. Right in the gut. Oh my gosh. So, captain's down. Like, down, down.
Make me proud.
First mission out, and the captain dies. That's not a good record to start off on.
We have target lock, Captain.
Do I fire, or do I not? Oh, I do. Ooh, I fired. I'm like Will Riker in that Borg episode. Fire. Torpedo. I have fired, and I have struck. There's the Klingon ship. It's gonna fall like a duck.
Direct hit! Casualties on all decks! Shields! Shields! Fire our weapons!
Shields! Shields!
Weapons and shields are offline! Cloak and begin repairs!
We've lost their signal.
How can you still
what now?
After that? That's a good question. What now? Speak to Eliza Flores up here on the bridge.
We survived. But the captain... Captain Taggart knew what would happen. And he gave the order anyway. The ultimate sacrifice. One that we all might be called to make someday. He trusted you to take command. All we can do now is survive. And remember him.
So, literally the captain died, and this is now a ship full of cadets. Think about that. I have resolved the tutorial training cruise, and I have picked up a new training mission. Gotta take a seat, though. Take command is our new tutorial now.
Eliza Flores is now your bridge officer.
So here's the space
bridge
part.
Officers add abilities to your ship in space and accompany you on away missions on the ground.
So Eliza Flores is now part of my bridge officer crew. She's a human Starfleet tactical bridge officer. So two tacticals here, a female cadet. Awesome. I will change uniform and all that later.
All decks reporting in, sir. We took some casualties, and sick bay is full. All ship systems have taken some damage, but some are worse than others. Life support is stable, but anything else could be an issue.
Tavrel, send out a distress call.
I have been trying to get a distress call out, Captain, but something is jamming all frequencies.
Keep trying. Eliza, what's the status of the Klingon ship?
She's still cloaked, but I think she took some real damage. We're in rough shape too, Captain.
Zarva, damage report.
Still running diagnostics, sir. Took us some time to get the systems back online.
What about the break-even? Hail them.
Hailing the break-even now, Captain.
SS break-even, this is the Starfleet vessel Andromeda. What is your status?
Hello, Starfleet. No hard feelings, right? I had to send that distress signal. If I didn't, that crazy Klingon was going to blow my ship into space junk. And, because Starfleet's always ready to help and all, could you help me repair my ship? I'm grateful for all you've done to save my ship and cargo already. But the sooner I can get out of here, the sooner I'll be safe from Kadek.
Mm-hmm. I'll see what I can do.
Increase your speed using E. Decrease your ship speed by using W and S to move up or down. Use A and D to turn left or right.
I am not going to love how slow the
full stop.
Is.
I've stopped us this time, sir, but from now on, you'll be responsible for adjusting the speed of the ship.
Scan the freighter.
Looks like she just needs 3 or 4 warp induction coils. We have plenty of those to spare.
Position yourself near the ship and press F to interact with it.
Thanks! We'd help you if we could, but I just don't see any profit in that, you know?
He's gone.
Well, looks like we're on our own. At least they said thank you, I guess. About that cloaked ship full of Klingons?
Zarva, do you have that damage report?
Almost done, Captain. Level 2 diagnostics shows that almost all of the plasma injectors are damaged beyond repair.
Do you have replacements?
Not enough. Plasma injectors are made to withstand quite a beating, but I think the Klingons specifically sabotaged them when they boarded us. It's an easy way to cripple a ship. I'm installing what spares we have, but we're short 3 injectors. Without them, we can't go to warp.
Any ideas?
We're not the first ship the Klingons have hit here. There's wreckage all over this region. I can scan the derelicts and see if any of them have intact plasma injectors.
Do it. Do it. Scan for parts. Now we're gonna salvage parts.
Bingo! I found some suitable debris in the boneyard nearby. Destroy 3 of those nacelles, and we should get the parts we need.
Well, okay then.
Press the space bar to fire energy weapons.
Warning, ship is under attack.
An item has dropped for you. Move towards the item and press F to loot it.
Taking through scraps we've left behind.
Yeah, that guy's getting annoying.
These plasma injectors will do the trick, sir. Gorgeous technology. Type R, if I had to guess. 3.7-liter flow put with shielded reservoirs and a drop flow induction coil.
That's what I was talking about. So it told me how I can right-click each weapon and set it to auto-fire, which I naturally always do anyway. That's good, but remember, the Klingons who want us dead, I need you to work fast.
You have your problems, I have mine. I'll need some time to get everything installed and run a level 1 diagnostic. We don't want to blow up the moment we hit warp 1.
Zarva's dealing with the warp core, but until she's done, we're still stranded out here with no way to call for help. Oh, don't forget the cloaked Klingon battlecruiser. It's probably making repairs faster than we are.
Eliza is so upbeat, given the circumstance we're in. Any chance we can determine what's jamming communications?
Of course we can. We're the class of 2409.
Oh, right.
Tevrel has been working with the engineers, and they've pinpointed the locations of several Klingon signal jammers. That's what blocked our communications during the ambush. I recommend that we destroy the jamming satellites. We'll be able to get a call out to Starfleet then.
Okay.
You must be within 10 kilometers of an enemy to attack it. Use your plasma beam to weaken shielded targets.
Plasma beam?
Use your torpedoes on an enemy when their shield is down.
I think we just found an error. I don't have a plasma beam, but I do have phaser beams. Maybe that's what it means.
Warning, ship is under attack.
Let's go to attack so we get more weapon power there.
Nice shot. two more jamming
target
satellites left.
Has failed.
I haven't forgotten about you. Think your ship can take a couple more hits?
Maybe. He's in a Negvar.
Long-range communications are operational, sir. Shall I send the distress signal?
Yes, send.
That Klingon ship took some real damage. I'll bet she's leaking plasma all over the place. We might be able to use that to find them.
Do it.
Understood. I'd rather not die to Klingons on my first day. Got it. I can trace the plasma signature right to the source.
Finally.
I'll send the source of the plasma signature to navigation. It will show up on the map.
Make it so.
It's pretty far out, sir. We should use the ship's full impulse power to reach it. This will temporarily take power from other systems, but vastly improve our speed. Once we drop out of full impulse, the power will return to other systems.
Yep.
Full impulse. I can make your death swift.
Activate full impulse by...
Go. There we go. Full impulse to suspect point. Follow the plasma trail. I have torpedo high yield 1 as our first tactical power.
Hover your mouse over a weapon and its firing arc will be shown around your ship in space.
While I think
activate
I can.
Activate high yield torpedo by clicking on the icon or pressing Alt and 1. High yield torpedo will increase the power of your next torpedo attack.
Good, I like that. Nice little tutorial on how to use our first power we have. And of course, I did put all energy to attack, so we have energy to weapons, so that we can get the maximum firepower.
Click on a shield that is low on power to direct power to it. This will divert power from your other shields.
Target shield has failed.
It is going to take some time getting used to this ship again. This starter ship here. That is the worst.
Click on a shield that is low on power to direct power to it. This will divert power from your other shields.
No. Oh, I got her. She's dead.
Ship explosions cause damage. Put some distance between yourself and exploding ships.
Yep, figured that one out. Okay.
Incoming transmission, sir. It is from Starfleet.
On screen, Tavarel.
This is Captain Volok of the USS Renown. Do you require assistance?
Yes, sir. We were ambushed by Klingon marauders.
A Klingon captain would have to be very bold to travel this far into Federation territory.
I agree.
Where is Captain Taggart?
Well, about Taggart, we got a little bit of a problem there. He was captured and taken by the Klingon ship and then killed, and they killed him after he ordered us to fire on his position.
And did you follow his orders?
Oh yeah, I followed his orders. I fired on his butt.
So, I take it you are in command now.
Oh yeah, I'm in command. Who's the man? Who's the woman? Me.
Very well. We will escort your ship to Earth space dock.
What about the Klingon who killed Captain Taggart, sir? Kadek is still out there.
And if he reveals his position, he will be dealt with accordingly. Until then, you are to set a course for our position. Renown out.
Ooh, yes, sir. Doesn't sound like he's very happy with me. Why doesn't the ship come to us? Why do we have to go to it? And did he sound a little PO'd with me? I think so. I don't think he's so happy. Okay, here I am. And there's the Klingons we tried to warn you about, but you just shrugged them off like they were nothing.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Your captain begged for his life before I killed him.
Accepting danger is part of being a Starfleet officer.
I'm tired
of
this!
You have learned this lesson well.
It's time to finish this fight!
No, Chop, it is time for me to finish you.
My house will avenge me!
Sure, whatever. We win, you lose.
The Renown will escort you back to Earth space dock. But first we must inform the USS Kittimer that... One moment. My communications officer informs me that we are unable to contact the Kittimer. We will proceed to their coordinates to determine if they require assistance, and your ship will accompany us. I hereby grant you a field promotion. This will give you the proper authority over your crew, and final decision-making ability for your ship until we reach Earth space dock and report to Admiral Quinn.
So I'm getting a field promotion, but am I getting a field promotion to what? What am I getting a field promotion to? Okay, so this is an actual completion of one of the tutorials called... Command or first command or whatever. So we're going to get a bunch of skill points, 12,000. Notice we are still a cadet right now, and I think that's about to change. Hyper impulse engine is a Mark 1 hyper impulse engine. That's going to help. A phaser beam array Mark 1 uncommon is going to help. A phaser split beam rifle Mark 1 uncommon. And we're going to get Zarva, who will be a female engineering bridge officer. Excellent.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
So there we go. This is our first technical level up. We are no longer a cadet. We are now Lieutenant 2. In fact, we've jumped over Lieutenant and gone straight to Lieutenant 2. Or Lieutenant 1, I mean. So we were a cadet, and then we skipped over Starfleet Lieutenant. New ship, unlock Federation Diplomatic Corps, and unlock Transwarp. We are now level 2, which means we gain evasive maneuvers and access to patrol missions. So we can actually do patrol missions at this level. And we get evasive maneuver space power, which as you can see was already added to my bar down here, but I can move that to, you know, a different location, and I don't need these there. I'll work on that bar and everything a little later. Zarva, reporting for duty. So I've got a Bolian engineering bridge officer female. She is going to give me emergency power to shields 1. Good for a cruiser type ship like I'm using here. So we need to exit to sector space.
Click to order your crew to plot a course to your next mission.
So literally, you are now in sector space. Here, ships
use
travel.
M to open up the map for sector space. You can click on a system to plot a course and set your ship to automatically fly to it.
Right, so, you know, we got all that. We're in sector space. If you look at the map, you'll see how everything's laid out. Sector space is how you get to all the missions and planets and everything. This is where you go to do your missions and stuff. We are already at the place we want to be, called Pollux 4. This is called Communication Breakdown. It says, investigate what happened to the USS Kittimer. Go to the Pollux system. Technically, this is still part of the tutorial, and I will tell you why. Because we'll go here and we'll look at the missions. And as you look at episodes, Klingon War, you will actually see that the first mission is actually called Stranded in Space. Welcome to Earth Space Dock is also part of a mission that hasn't even popped up yet, because technically we're still in the tutorial. So we can't even go to Earth Space Dock yet until we finish this tutorial. And then the first actual mission, quote, mission, is Stranded in Space. So this is still part of the tutorial. So I'm going to continue here and continue this video. We are not going to stop yet because this is still part of the tutorial.
We're here, Captain. The USS Kittimer is dead ahead and the Renown is beside us. Our orders are to make contact with the Kittimer and find out why they've not responded to our hails.
Very good. Set a course for the Kittimer. Now let's find out what happened here. Okay, hail the Kittimer. Static. Let's cut through this static. Boost the signal.
Yes, sir. I will require approximately 15 seconds to make the necessary adjustments.
She's very precise.
Captain Bullock. Captain Taggart? What are you both doing here?
Not Captain Taggart, sir. I am in command of the Andromeda. Captain Volok ordered me to come with him to your location.
Always good to follow the orders of your superior officers.
Do you know what happened with your communications?
These cadets were the unfortunate victims of a Klingon ambush. Captain Taggart is dead, and the ship is under the command of this cadet. The Renown was escorting them back to Earth's space dock, but when we could not raise the Kittimer, I deemed it imperative to alter our course and assess the situation. Captain Yim, what is your status?
Listen to Captain J. Yim.
I'm troubled by the anomalies in this system, and if they're affecting long-range communications, then they're doubly a cause for concern. Let's do this by the numbers. We've already launched 9 probes. Now that they're active, we can do an in-depth scan of the anomalies.
Okay.
With all 3 ships collecting data, we should be able to complete this quickly and formulate a course of action. The Renown has the largest science team, so I recommend we send our data there for analysis. Any questions?
No questions, sir. I'm confident that my crew is up to the task.
You're quite confident for a cadet. You remind me a bit of myself when I was an ensign. Of course, I wasn't commanding a ship back then. Let's see how you perform before you start claiming that chair full time.
Understood. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Again, being humble, probably wouldn't have said that, but...
You can set your ship's power levels to have a focus on attack, defense, speed,
I wanted
or balance.
To make my crew feel good. Okay, so this is telling us we can do attack, defense, or speed. Obviously, I'm going to go for attack so we get higher weapon power, so if we encounter any evil things out there, we can fire on them and actually do some damage. Would be nice. So we need to scan point Alpha, which is right here behind us.
Reports indicate traces of gamma radiation, but there's something off in the readings.
Okay, gamma radiation. Lovely. Hope we don't die from flying into this gamma radiation. Beta.
Kittimer here. Are you seeing the same gamma radiation levels that we are? I'm not sure that a normal scan will be enough. We might need to do a full multiphasic reading.
We saw the same issue. How can we improve our findings?
My chief science officer, Commander Davis, suggests that performing a reverse tachyon pulse wave scan will solve our sensor issue. Perform your final scans and then report back.
Yeah, I will just do that reverse tachyon thingamajig. Real easy. Not a problem. That's gonna solve it.
Deflector dish is realigned for reverse tachyon pulse wave, sir. Picking up a transwarp signature. It's right on top of us! The Borg!
The Borg! Literally,
lower your shields and prepare to be boarded. All life forms will be assimilated.
That was a rather haunting voiceover from the board.
The Kittimer is under attack. Use full impulse to reach her quickly.
Yep. I will when I can.
Activate full impulse by clicking on the arrow. Deactivate full impulse by clicking on it again.
So, the Borg, huh? Okay. Not a good start.
Warning. Ship
is under attack. From this time forward, your culture will adapt to service ours.
Target's shield has failed.
Okay, well, we defeated those Borg probes. That was kind of cool. But they really did a number on the Kittimer.
This is the emergency medical hologram aboard the USS Kittimer. I am requesting assistance from any Federation vessel in range. I've lost contact with the bridge. I am unable to contact Commander Davis for new instructions.
EMH, give me a situation report.
The Kittimer is being overwhelmed by Borg boarding parties. These Borg are different than the ones in my history records. They seem disconnected somehow. They're strange, but still quite dangerous.
Can you hold out on your own? We have problems of our own.
I am an emergency medical hologram, not a miracle worker.
Captain Warlock, what should we do?
The Borg were brutally efficient on the Kittimer. The emergency medical hologram may be in command simply because no one else is fit to do so. The Borg have not been seen in the Alpha Quadrant in decades. Their arrival cannot simply be a coincidence.
I agree.
However, I hesitate to speculate without the full data from all of the probes.
What do you need us to do?
I will send teams to aid the Kittimer. You will have to finish the scans. We need to know the extent of the Borg presence here. You must also inform me if you or your crew are unable to continue. The Borg evoke a strong emotional response. They can rattle even trained Starfleet officers. A crew of cadets that have already survived a Klingon attack may be unable to cope.
Good idea. Flores, what is our status?
We're scared. We all studied Admiral Janeway's Borg tactics, but no one thought we'd have to use them so soon.
Yeah, me either.
It's good that the Renown and Kittimer are here, but I know we need to be ready for the day when we're alone against the Collective. The counselors are already working with the crew. Do you want them to convey a message from you?
Let's see. No, we've wasted enough time. We have to finish those scans. Or tell them that we're Starfleet officers. We don't have the time to be afraid. Or, yes, tell them that I will do everything I can to protect this ship and her crew from the Borg. Let's do that.
Understood. I'll tell the crew what you said and set a course for the next anomaly. If the Borg show up again, we'll be ready.
I have linked the Iota point to your map. Scan there while we see to the Kittimer.
The crew need to hear from the captain, even if it's a lie. The crew need to hear from the captain that the captain is confident, knows what they're doing, and will do everything they can to protect the ship and that crew. Even if they are not capable of doing it, or they themselves are scared, the crew need to hear that. That is a truth. The crew will perform better.
Please transmit the data so we may begin our analysis.
Transmitting data, where are you?
We have your data, and our science team is analyzing it now.
Good. What's the status of the Kittimer?
Our tactical teams have eliminated the Borg boarding parties on the Kittimer. Why do you ask?
Can we use the Kittimer to help analyze the data?
There is an 88.47% chance that you will need my help.
Agreed. Can you help the Renown analyze the data? Or I'm suddenly having second thoughts. Nah, let's keep doing this. Analyze the data. Help us.
I have 75 million gigaquads of computer memory and an extensive library of files on military tactics and command strategies. I believe I can spare a few bits of processing power for you.
Let's see what we can determine. Continue data recovery.
Borg transwarp signatures detected. Prepare your ship for combat.
Really?
They're firing. I need help.
Let's go back over here then and help them.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
The Borg are only sending probes, though, so far, not spheres or cubes.
Target's shield has failed.
We're ready for this.
Well, it didn't matter. Because they're here and they're ready for this. Okay, let's get out of the middle of them. How about that? Holy crap, we're taking some damage. Way to start off.
Maintain your composure. Logically, you can defeat the Borg with Admiral Janeway's tactics.
Okay, the Borg assault.
You are Starfleet officers. You are prepared for this.
Oh, it's a transwarp gate right there.
Holy, multiple Borg warp signatures detected.
Okay, well, there's a lot of Borg now. There's
it's
a lot of
spheres. It's an invasion force.
Holy crap. Well, we need to get out of here.
We're outnumbered. There's no way we can...
Warning. Ship is under attack.
The Borg are departing, most likely for a more strategic target. Direct your fire at the remaining sphere.
Right.
Focus your fire, and we shall prevail.
I'm focused.
Direct hit.
Good. You'll notice I'm taking all the loot. This is something that I'll talk about more later on, but it's one way to
earn
energy.
Here is the situation as we see it. The Borg are using the Pollock system as a staging area for a larger invasion. Long-range sensors are already detecting inbound transwarp signatures. The most likely target for a first strike is the Vega system. There is a civilian colony there, and if the Borg could take it by surprise, they would have large numbers of new drones at their disposal.
Tactical option here. The Andromeda should go to Vega to warn the colonists.
Very observant of you. The Renown is better equipped to hold off further Borg attacks and assist the Kittimer. We must remain here. Once you have warned the colony, return to Earth's space dock.
Okay, let's
Most
do it.
Most missions can be turned in remotely.
Okay, so this one is actually done as far as...
It is imperative that you warn the colony at Vega of the impending attack. We will do what we can to hold off the Borg here in Vega and repair the Kittimer.
We're going to get a neutrino deflector array, a photon torpedo, Mark I, uncommon, a science console. We're going to get to Vrel. That's nice. So we get a science character. This is a science bridge officer, so we'll have science bridge officer powers. And we're going to get a captain power called Evasive Maneuver, which actually I already have.
We have to make our way to Vega as soon as we can, Captain. I just hope we're not too late to warn the colony.
And we
are you ready
up.
To go?
We are now Lieutenant 4. So we skipped over 3, access to fleet action missions, which we just got. Now we're Lieutenant 4, which means we are going to get, as a tactical officer, we're going to get a ground power called Target Optics. There's also an engineering power. If you're engineering, you get reroute power to shields. And if you're science, you get tricorder scan. But we are tactical, so our ground power is Target Optics. So we are getting a lot of things opening up here just through the tutorial. We also got Tavrel, a science officer, a female cadet. I like how my entire bridge crew are female. That's nice. So I think that's the theme I'm going to keep. That is really cool. Okay, this tutorial still going on, going quite well. The next part of it is Vega, which actually is still part of the tutorial.
Shields up, red alert.
We're gonna continue. Okay, they're having a bad day.
Ship is under attack.
Oh, they're not gonna survive. That's a lot of spheres, guys. A lot of spheres. That was a nice little battle there. So now we are Assimilation of the Innocent. Dire warning, go to the Vega system. So I actually need to find the Vega system. This is our first use of the map and navigation in trying to find systems, and that's to go to Vega. Now at this point, if you know what you're doing, if you're already familiar with the game, you played it a lot, you know you can go ahead and start equipping stuff on your character and so forth. Now, if you're a new player, you might not know you can do this. But you can do this anytime you're out of combat. That's the only stipulation, you're not in combat. Hit U, and I can start equipping stuff. Like on my character, I've got this better weapon. I have, as far as ground stuff goes, I guess that's it. As far as space goes, I have so many new items here that I can put on my ship and start using. But if you don't know you can do that, I'll go ahead and leave these off because we're still going through the tutorial. We still haven't got to the first mission, which is stranded in space. So let's pretend that I don't know all that stuff. And, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and continue this tutorial until we get to Earth Space Dock. So we'll just leave everything like it is. And I'll show you that you can still succeed through this tutorial just with the standard stuff I have on my ship and my ground character. Begin assimilation of the innocent.
We arrived before the Borg. Now my heart can start beating again. What are your orders, Captain?
Hail the colonies. We have to...
Tavrell managed to establish a comm link with Willa Post, the administrator of Vega Colony. It's not a great signal, but it's the best we're gonna get. Putting her through now.
On screen. Greetings, Captain. Is there something I can do for you today?
The Borg are on their way. You need to start evacuating.
Repeat, please. Your signal is breaking up. Did you say the Borg? What about them?
They're on their way. Get out of there.
I have lost contact with Vega Colony, sir. Something is blocking all subspace signals in this area. Even our hails to the civilian ships are not getting through. There is a communication satellite nearby. It should boost our signal sufficiently to inform the freighters of the danger and warn the colony.
Set a course for the satellite. Hello, satellite. Boost signal.
Our hails are still blocked, sir. The Borg may be attempting to isolate the planet before they land. Your order, sir.
Zarva, can we get a transporter lock on the colonists?
Borg are jamming up any remote signals. It's not safe to beam through that. I think I can boost the gain, though.
Hurry, I think the Borg will be here any...
Transwarp conduits
now.
Opening all over the system, Captain! The Borg are here.
Are they really? Didn't notice. All right, I gotta defeat 5.
Those civilian ships are right in the Borg's path. We have to help them.
That's a lot of invasion forces. Let's do it.
One ship is under attack.
Oh, I got a science sea power. Tachyon beam 1. No, don't fire on that probe. Fire on this one. So I've actually got all 3 of my bridge officer powers now.
Target's shield has failed.
This one is a shield drain. Target foe, minus 98.6, all shields, each pulse, 10 pulse max. So this will be good for draining shields on enemies. Accolade complete, entrenched engineering. A planetary assimilation probe. That's different. Failed. Boy, look at them! Look at them go! Let's see if we can get over here and help these transports.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Do a shield drain. My tachyon beam. That'll help bring the shield down on the probe.
Target shield
has failed.
That's very
cool. And now we will do a high-yield photon torpedo and destroy them. There it goes. 2 torpedoes. 1 killed them anyway. Nice. Alright, one more invasion force. I guess this planetary probe. Do a shield drain on it. This has a very short cooldown time, so that's nice. No, 20-second cooldown, never mind. Anyway, that's done. Now I need to consult with my crew.
Captain, I have short-range communications. Long-range signals are still blocked. I can contact the planet and have informed Administrator Post of the situation. However, the Borg have already landed and are moving toward the colony. It may be more prudent to retreat back to the Renown, sir.
We make our stand here, Cadet. Look for any more Borg landing parties, or we're the only Starfleet vessel in the system. We'll rescue as many colonists as possible. Because that's what Starfleet does. Continuing invasion.
Borg landing craft detected nearby. Captain, there are civilian ships engaging them.
I believe I can send a message to those ships.
Okay. So, do it.
Civilian ships, you are ordered to disengage and retreat. We will cover you.
A lot of Borg ships here.
Roger that, Starfleet. All ships, fall back.
I like the
all
looks of that
ship. All civilian ships have safely warped out of the system, Captain.
It's a different looking Borg ship right there.
Target's shields have failed.
Come on, come on. Die, Borg. There's four, and here comes five.
Target's
shield. Tachyon beam. And a high yield. That is a cool looking ship. Nice. Accolade complete. Holding the line. You've destroyed 20 Borg ships. Now let's go to Vega.
Captain, the Borg have landed, and the colony won't be able to hold them off for long. I recommend beaming down to Vega and getting as many people out as we can.
Beam down.
Choose your away team for your next mission. Your choices for who will be on your away team will grow as you recruit more bridge
officers.
Let's
take Flores with us. She's cool. We have the same hair.
Captain, according to our readings, over half the planet is already assimilated by the Borg. At the rate they're progressing, the region we're in will be overrun in roughly 1 hour. And if that wasn't bad enough, the interference is affecting the ship's transporters.
Understood. We will manually tag any survivors we find for transport.
No, sir. I'll follow your lead.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna fight some Borg. Ooh, let's not go that way, though. Here we go.
That's one of those Borg ships from orbit. Are we too late?
I do like
those landing ships
looks.
Don't just carry drones. They can pump nanoprobes directly into the ground and the atmosphere. We need to hurry.
Running.
The Borg will be in this area soon.
Running and stumbling. Tag refugees, one of two. There. Tag
Thank
refugees.
You. We didn't know if anyone from Starfleet got our distress signal, and we don't have any weapons. But we do have some spare armor suits for you and your officer. They're in the crates next to the gate.
Oh, good.
This code will open the gate. Please, Administrator Post and some of the others are still there. You have to save them.
So we're going to get some armor.
Press the U key to view your status, or the status of your ship and bridge officers. This is your character. Here you can see your equipped items and devices. You can also view your ship's equipment. Equip your bridge officer by selecting them, and then double-clicking an item in your inventory.
Now that it's given us the tutorial on this, we can use these items, so let's go ahead and put it on here. This is just regular standard, as you see, body armor, energy dampening, plus 10 kinetic and all energy damage resistance rating, so nothing big here, but at least it gives us something. I would rather have something rather than nothing, so let's put that on Rami, and let's give Eliza body armor as well. That'll help her. Now she's got some resists to stuff. There we go, 9.3%, and I have 9.1%. I wonder why she's a little higher. Now, as for my weapons, these were terrible weapons to begin with. Let's put on this one. This is a phaser split beam Mark 1 with a damage modifier. This is an uncommon. As you can see, it does 49.9 DPS. Very, very basic, but it's going to be better than that one was. There's a comparison on that, just a little bit more damage. But Eliza probably needs better. She only has a phaser beam pistol. So I'll go ahead and give her what I was using before, which is the phaser sniper rifle. That way, she will have a better weapon now. Now, as far as other ground items go, that's all that I've got so far on ground, so... I don't even want hypo sprays. I don't use those. We'll sell them for EC later. I'll explain all that. But now we're a little bit better. She does have a shield. Okay, good. A personal shield. And I just have a personal shield as well. No kits yet. But now we are a little bit better. As good as we can get, at least for ground. So look at us. There's my weapon. There's hers. And we both have the armor on. So excellent. We are ready for this, as ready as can be at this stage of the game.
Oh no, we're too late.
Defeat Borg and beam out captured civilians. This I can do. Beam out. I guess y'all are gonna beam out together. Okay, that's good. Look at these Borg groups here. Wow. Hey, that one's gonna beam out without me. This group.
We have the civilians. There is still no sign of the Renown or the Kittimer, sir.
Okay, fine. Beam away on me. Good. I need to talk to the administrator.
I apologize for Koles putting a rifle in your face. If it wasn't for him, the Borg would have assimilated me by now. What's the situation?
What? What happened? Where did you go? Why did you move?
I apologize for Koles putting a rifle in your face. If it wasn't for him, the Borg would have assimilated me by now. What's the situation? Are you bringing more Starfleet reinforcements?
We're the only ones here. The Andromeda is in orbit.
I see. And it's
very
true.
Depressing, I
Vega
know.
Is doomed. A single starship cannot hope to stop this. Still, there is more to do. Many citizens are hiding in their homes. We cannot abandon them to the Borg.
Well, we can rescue them, but something is blocking our transport.
I know. Koles and I have been trying to get around the interference field. Thank you for tagging the people you found and getting them safely transported to your ship.
Well, that can't be everyone.
No, there are dozens more hiding out in the buildings. But Koles and I have a plan. We think a pattern enhancer will do the trick. With that, we can transport the remaining citizens to your ship. But first, I'd like to offer you some equipment. Vega was a trade colony, and this gear was intended to go to Starbase 65. I think you need it more.
Ah, take a kit and then set up the pattern enhancers. So, this is our first kit we're going to get. I love it. Let's see what we get here. As a tactical officer...
You have received a kit appropriate to your profession. Open your inventory, default key I, and double-click it to equip it. With a kit equipped, abilities are added to your action bar that you can perform in ground combat.
Or you can hit you. Okay, so here's our kit. Now, as I mentioned, tactical is a lot about buffing and debuffing, that sort of stuff. This one is a tactical kit, standard issue. Let's see what it comes with. It comes with, does it come with any abilities? It does come with one. It comes with a photon grenade. So this is not one of those
that I was talking about. You now have additional abilities in ground combat.
But it does have a cool power. It has a grenade, which is a very active tactical power, very common one, obviously. This is called a Photon Grenade Mark 1. It does area of effect damage and knockback, 92 kinetic damage, 50% shield penetration damage. So this is a really nice, a real general, because there's other type of grenades, but this is a real general grenade, a good starter grenade that you can throw as a tactical officer. Now, there's a difference here between a kit and a kit module. The kit is not the power. The power comes from the module. So here's the kit. The kit is actually called a tactical kit standard issue, which has one assault module slot. That's what's important about this kit. It's only got one slot, and it's an assault slot. So only assault modules can go in it, and only one. So the assault module we have in it is called the Photon Grenade. So two different things. This grenade, you see, can be taken off the kit just like that, or put it back on it. So the kit is the kit that holds the modules. Now the kit also has certain powers, and right now this one doesn't have any. It's just a standard kit. But as you go up in level and quality and all that in the game, different kits will have powers of their own or buffs of their own, like more weapon damage or different things like that. So there are other things to look at with kits themselves beyond what modules they support. But we'll get into that when we get into better kits and all that, when we get better kits in the game. But right now we're just going to have this photon. Now also, in order to use the photon grenade, you obviously have to put a button on your hotbar or you can't use it. So hit P or hit this little button here, or this button here. That'll bring it up. This button brings it up, or you can just hit P on your keyboard and there you go. And you want to make sure you put these powers on your power tray down here, or you won't be able to use them. So these are all my powers available to me on ground. Here's the new photon grenade I got. I need a button for it. Now this is the other thing I got. This is that target optics. Remember when we looked up here at Lieutenant, I told you we got this thing called target optics at level 4. Well, that is one of my tactical officer powers. I just have to use it. It was down here on my bar. I just needed to make sure a button was down there for it, and it is now. So I got photon grenade and target optics on there. So when I get to an enemy, I can throw this grenade at them. I will use that. And also, I can use this target optics ability. Now, this is one of those things that's all about buffing and debuffing and everything. Look at this one. This one affects the foe. That means you need to click on the foe first. You need to click on your enemy. Then you activate this power. What this will do is, to yourself, it will give you plus 15% all damage for 15 seconds versus that foe. To you, it will give a plus 1.5% critical chance for 15 seconds to that foe that you selected. To yourself, you get a plus 15% critical severity for 15 seconds to that foe. And to yourself, you get a plus 15 perception for 15 seconds to that foe you selected. I will show you how you use that. All those are beneficial, especially the all damage and critical chance and severity. Because basically, I'm now going to automatically be doing 15% more damage when I'm using that ability, and I'll have a higher chance of doing a critical severity shot. I'll show you how you use that. Let's do this this pattern and answer here.
We have lowered shields for the transporter, sir. I will need to raise them at the first sign of Borg ships.
Uh-huh.
The pattern enhancers are working. And not a moment too soon. I can hear the Borg moving this way. I'll do that. How long do you think you can hold off the Borg?
As long as we need to, because we're that good. All right, let's watch. I think the Borg will come through here, maybe? Hold off the Borg while civilians transport out. Maybe they won't.
Remember when we thought fighting a crazed Klingon was the worst thing that could happen today?
Okay, notice how I am selecting the Borg, selecting the enemy, and then doing target
off. Concentrate fire on the Borg. We need to
now
keep them away from
my
the civilians.
Thing, and I'm doing extra damage with that and my weaponry. That is how you have to do it.
Another group of civilians has beamed to the ship, Captain.
I'll show you again on the next group. Okay, so select the Borg, target. Oh, my target optics is not cooled down. That's a problem. You have to wait for the cooldown. There's my photon torpedo. Excellent. That does a lot of damage anyway, right now at least. Even if it's a standard torpedo. These Borg aren't, they aren't the kind of Borg that you will get at endgame. These are much easier, so very different. Okay, now I should be able, there we go. Select the Borg. There we go. Bam. And then fire and shoot. See how well that works together, that combination of powers? So you gotta remember to use your kit powers. Very important, very important. Kit powers. I need to answer the hail from my ship, apparently.
Shields are back up, sir, but more Borg vessels are warping to our location. We have detected a type of generator near your position. There is a 94.6% chance it is the device affecting our transporters. If you can destroy it, we will transport as many people from the area as we are able.
Okay, hang in there, Tavarel. We'll be there soon.
Thank you for everything you've done. Even though it was impossible to save everyone, those you did save will be forever in your debt.
I'm not finished yet. Kolez, you're with me.
Glad to do anything I can. I was born on Vega. There's no way I'm sitting by and letting the Borg take it without a fight.
All right,
Kolez, you're gonna see friends who've been assimilated. Don't
I know the drill.
Hesitate.
Just never expected any Borg here, you know.
Well, there are. Kolez is with me. Oh, he needs help bad. Oh, I need to activate the console. I'm waiting for it to open. I have to actually open it myself. Imagine that. Okay, now we're going to select Borg. Watch this when I can. Select, do that, and then we can throw a grenade and do a whole bunch of damage. Check that out. Killed them all with grenades. Wasn't that cool?
That one. We played poker last night.
Yeah, well, now you're not. You're playing poker. That makes no sense. Borg poker is what I was trying to go for there, but that didn't work together.
We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
Really?
The Borg are activating the transport inhibitor. We need to disable that force field.
Okay. Disable the force field generator. Well, let's get through these Borg. Here's the tactical drone. So again, target optics.
The Borg are so,
tactical drone.
What's the word? Effective?
Now
systematic?
I can do more damage
evil.
To it.
I'm gonna go with evil.
I wouldn't say they're evil. They're just, they're aiming for perfection. It's not a bad goal, it's just the way they're going around it. So they're not evil, they're just going about it the wrong way.
We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
Borg 101. Oh, he's going down fast. And he wasn't much threat at all.
The ship is transporting anyone they can get a lock on, Captain, but we don't have much time. We need to get back as soon as possible.
Let's beam out. So, basically the thing here to remember on ground as a tactical officer is that target optics. You're always going
to
have
We're packed to the brim with civilians, Captain. I don't think we could fit one more soul on this ship. Communications are still jammed, so we can't reach the Renown or the Kittimer. The immediate problem is the civilian ships in this system. Vega's a huge trading outpost. There are always ships traveling here. We need to warn them the Borg have taken over.
Can we reconfigure the satellites in this system to send an automated warning?
Possibly. But
we
what we need to do is hightail it out of here with these civilians. Of course, the path to the satellites does lead away from the planet, so we could remotely reconfigure them as we leave. The message won't get very far, but anyone who enters the system will get the signal and be able to turn around before it's too late.
Yeah, that's the thing, the plan. Let's do it. Oh, look at that. The land masses have been Borgified. That is cool. I didn't know it did that. Nice. Okay, satellite, reconfigure.
Multiple probes inbound. I don't think the Borg like us hanging around.
Well, they can just deal with it.
Target's shields have failed. Four shields failing.
Okay, they mean business. The high-yield torpedo. I've got plasma burn on me right now. The Borg deal plasma damage, and they leave this plasma burn effect on your ship like this right here. But I can't get rid of it because I don't have the proper power hazard emitter to do that at this time. So I'm just going to have to live with it.
Target's shields have failed.
Oh boy, I've got to do that again. I got to do a second beacon now. Took a lot of damage from that fight with three probes. Boy, this ship cannot take a lot. Three probes. Wow, and it did that to me. Okay, configured a second beacon on the way out. I have a feeling we're going to hit another group of Borg.
Never thought I'd wish I was back at the Academy studying for the astrometrics final.
Great. A sphere. This is going to be rough, but I'm going to use to bring down the shield, and then I'm going to do a high yield torpedo. And see if that makes a difference. I think I hit him with the shield mostly down, so that helped a little bit, but not a lot. Do a shield heal, which also gives me reduces damage to shields by 18% for 30 seconds, which is real nice. That's what the emergency powered shield does. So that's a nice after effect of the shield. Kind of reduces damage to the shield for a little time. So that's a cool ability to use. Except when the shields go down, it's not so cool.
Sir, there are several fast-moving ships on sensors. No way to contact them, and I can't tell if they're friend or foe.
We'll find out soon enough, won't we? Man, that sphere did a lot of damage to me. This is the final beacon we need to configure, at least. Who wants to bet? Let's put down money. Who wants to bet that a cube is going to pop up for me here at the end? Yep.
Lower your shields and prepare to be boarded. All life forms will be assimilated.
Eat my exhaust.
A cube? Guess it's our time to go out in a blaze of glory.
First outing as a cadet, and all of this is happening. We'll talk about that at the end of the video here, because it's pretty crazy for a cadet's first adventures out.
Exceptional.
I am doing no damage
now,
to this cube.
Let us finish this.
And I need to get away from it. I'm way too close. At least the cavalry came. Gosh, I needed their help.
Target shields have failed.
Okay, I just wanted to get away from the thing. I was so close to it. Now we can shoot it with some torpedoes. And a shield drain. See that effect there? That's the shield drain effect. Now that the shield facing is down, I can hit him with a torpedo. Would be nice.
Target's
We got him. There go my torpedoes. Yes, we got him with my last two torpedoes. I am awesome.
We held off what we could in Pollux and sent a signal out to Starfleet. These were the closest ships. Others will be arriving as soon as they can.
Glad to see you. There's no way we could have defeated a cube by ourselves.
You have handled things well thus far.
You think?
Excellent thinking on reconfiguring the satellites into warning beacons. We received the signal as soon as we arrived in the system. I will be discussing that option with the other captains here, but your priority is to protect the civilians you have on board, as well as to ensure the safety of your crew. The Kittimer will return to Earth space dock with you. Once you arrive, report to Admiral Quinn. He will have more information for you.
Good. Go to Earth space dock.
You and your crew have done well. Coles would make a fine addition to your senior staff.
I agree. Okay, skill points, expertise. We're going to get a phaser full auto rifle. So a different type of phaser. It is a Mark 1 uncommon. A neutronium alloy Mark 2. So our first Mark 2 item. Plus 5 kinetic and all energy damage. This is for our ship. And we're going to get Coles, who is a tactical officer and is a Saurian male. But it doesn't have that Saurian trait of efficiency. Anyway, continue.
Congratulations.
Captain Polak told us to get to Earth space dock, and I think he's right. We need to get the civilians to safety. And I don't think I can handle any more excitement.
Yeah, we've kind of had a lot. I am now a Lieutenant 5, so now we PvP is unlocked. Another bridge officer is awarded. Okay, warp to Earth space dock. This is where the game really begins, now that the tutorial is pretty much almost over here. This just shows us a little bit of Earth space dock. What it's showing us actually is how to get to Quinn. A lot of people will probably ask, you know, where's Quinn, how to get to Quinn. He is behind the water flow device here, so this is just showing us that there's an area back here, because a lot of people wouldn't know this is back here, and this is where you actually find Quinn. So there you go, a nice camera pan right to Quinn, so we know where to go. Coles is a Saurian male cadet. Okay, good. Now I'm in my clothing now, so I do not have my cadet clothing anymore. You will notice this is the clothing I chose in the first video. This is the first time we get to see our character actually wearing the clothes that we chose, so that is cool. Or was it on before, previously? I need to rewatch that and see. I might have had it on the planet down there on Vega. I didn't look at that. So if I did, I apologize. So this other thing here is showing us where to go to get to Quinn. See, we need to meet with Admiral Quinn. That is literally our first thing to do here on Welcome to Earth Space Dock. Hello, Quinn. Greetings, Lieutenant. I have new orders for you. Admiral, sir, Rami Summers reporting. Now, if you are into PvP, I guess you could start doing PvP now and pick that up. I don't recommend that. I recommend just continuing with the main storyline. Do PvP later when you have figured out the game. Alright, we have a lot to discuss. Yes, I see that here in the report transmitted by Captain Volok, he granted you a field promotion to give you seniority over the rest of the active crew of your ship. As a cadet, you were assigned to an academy training course under Captain Mass Taggart, correct, Acting First Officer? Yeah, that's correct. I've read the reports. Facing off against Klingon raiders and a Borg invasion force within hours of leaving Starfleet Academy is very unusual. Well, I agree. In your own words, tell me what happened out there. Okay, explain the whole thing. That's quite the story. Yes, sir, and it's all true. I didn't make up one bit. Except for the part about the purple one-eyed monster. But that's a whole different thing. Don't worry, I have statements here from Captains Volok and Yim and Willa Post from Vega Colony. It's like he doesn't believe me, so I have to get all these statements from these other captains. All three of them cite your bravery and command skills as well, and your crew's willingness to put yourselves in harm's way to preserve the lives of others. I'm a Starfleet officer, sir. It's in the job description. And you're exactly the kind of officer Starfleet needs. I know that your ship might not be the Enterprise, but I think you've proven yourself capable of sitting in her captain's chair, sir. Under normal circumstances, it would take you years of work to get your own command. But these are not normal circumstances. We're at war with the Klingon Empire. The Borg have returned. I'm losing more trained officers and ships than I can spare. Ships we can build, but not leaders. But leaders with courage and honor. Those are harder to find. It's time to try something different. I need someone who can handle themselves in a crisis and get the best out of their crew. Even though you're young, I think you are that person. I hereby promote you to the rank of lieutenant and give you command of the USS Andromeda. Don't disappoint me. So here I am, a lieutenant, straight out of the cadet. Literally, I've had one mission and all heck broke loose. Now I'm a lieutenant and I'm in command of my own ship. Doesn't make any sense in the world. Yet here it is happening. You won't regret this, sir. Your orders are what is going to happen to Vega. No, but I am sorry for the loss of Captain Taggart. So let's see. What's going to happen to... let's say I'm sorry for the loss of Captain Taggart, because he was my first captain I served under. Captain Taggart was a good man and a fine officer, Lieutenant. He knew what he was doing when he issued that order. Don't dwell on what happened. Your actions saved the lives of your crew, not to mention the civilians you were able to evacuate from Vega Colony. Now it's up to you and your crew to honor Taggart's sacrifice as you carve out your own legacy. Do you have any further questions? What's going to happen to Vega? Unfortunately, the Renown and her task force were not able to repair the Borg. Vega is lost. Starfleet Command will meet with Federation President Anak Okeg and the Federation Council to determine our next steps. For now, Starfleet vessels will patrol the outskirts of the Vega system to ensure no Borg escape. So basically, the Vega colony is now the Borg colony. Great, we have let the Borg in. What are your orders, sir? Let's see, you will be assigned to the Klingon front. But first, you could use some new equipment for the Andromeda. I have some improved consoles developed by the Starfleet Corps of Engineers. These consoles can be installed on your ship to improve its abilities. As you improve in rank, you will earn better consoles. Other ships you will command throughout your career will have space for many more. When you're done here, go see Durs Rax to customize your starship's appearance. Oh, okay. You will receive the following rewards: skill points, expertise, a free starship modification, phaser beam array Mark II with crit D, console tactical phaser relay, and a battery pack.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Accolade complete, battlefield commission. I am now my own captain. I got all these things. I am now Lieutenant 6, which I don't get anything new. I've got a lot of new stuff. I mean, since I started the tutorial, I've gone from cadets to Lieutenant 6. Wow. Okay, now we could do the first mission stranded in space, but we're not yet, because that's going to be in the next video. So in this video, we did the entire tutorial, and it is quite lengthy, but all of that was the tutorial. All of that's really part of the tutorial, because the first mission is called Stranded in Space. When you look under episodes in Klingon War, Stranded in Space is the first mission. Now, I have something to say about all that. I mean, here I am, a cadet, straight out of the academy. I mean, straight out of the academy. The first captain I serve with dies. Well, first of all, he made me first officer, which was a little questionable in the first place. But second of all, he dies. Then, I have to go to war with a Klingon who causes a lot of trouble for me and kills my captain. Then, out of the blue, nowhere, the Borg that you think would be this thing that you don't encounter until in-game, or this thing that, you know, you wouldn't think to see as a lieutenant as your first day out on the job. The Borg. You're facing the Borg. I mean, come on. A whole colony gets taken over. You have to rescue people on the ground. You have to rescue people in space. This is a lot for a cadet to go through. So that is a wild ride as far as the intro goes. So, you know, I like the idea that they're trying to get across here. It teaches you all the things you basically need to know being introduced to Star Trek Online. But I kind of think, you know, maybe they could have scaled it back in the things you encounter. Perhaps maybe a little more about going through the academy and graduating the academy and how you get your first ship. You know, all of that is just, it's like, wow, I'm getting my first ship as a lieutenant. I'm an actual captain now. That doesn't make any sense, right? Because you don't really have your own ship until you're like captain, not lieutenant. But anyway, it is what it is. I am what I am. So as I mentioned, as a tactical officer, your very first tactical power that's very useful is going to be this target optics. Just make sure to use it on the ground a lot. You'll have it from the start of the game until the finish of the game. It's going to be with you forever, and it's going to increase in power. So you will want to use target optics on the ground. That's just always going to be something that helps you. That plus 15% all damage is so useful. And the critical chance and severity improvement is also useful. I mean, this is a very, very, very highly useful tactical ability you will want to use. All right, now I have got a lot of things. I got a lot of ship parts and things I can do on my ship. And in fact, he wanted me to go customize my ship. I don't know why. Customize the look of my ship. We can choose to do that, or we can go straight to the first mission. But what I like to do, instead of jumping straight to the next mission, if I'm going to be a good Star Trek Online player, I need to spend a little time, give my character a little time, a little attention, a little finesse, work with my character. The more time I spend with her and on her and give her, the better she will perform for me. And by that I mean spend time going over all of the equipment I have on her and my bridge officers, going over the equipment I have on my ship, how I have my ship set up, going over the stations, going over the bridge officers I have, and setting everything up. There's a lot we can do just at this stage of the game, even just finishing the tutorial. There are a ton of things we can do to better ourselves on ground and space before we even jump into the next mission. And I recommend spending that time here on Earth Space Dock and doing that. Again, the more time you spend with your character and your ship, the better they will do for you in the missions. And this playthrough is not just about getting in here and playing the missions. This playthrough is to show everybody how you can build a good character and a good ship if you just spend a little time with them. So what I'm going to do is, before the next mission, before Stranded in Space, I will make another video after this one, and it is going to go through all of that. We're going to work on putting all the gear and stuff on my character to make her good, make her solid, so that on ground she'll be awesome. I'm going to go through the bridge officers and pick out which ones I want to use on ground, and I'm going to equip them well. I'm going to go through the ship. I'm going to equip the ship well. I'm going to go through all of that and make sure all my space powers and ground powers are how I want them. If you start out, number one, with the powers you want to use, you will be successful. If you just go with the powers the game gives you, you'll have an experience, but it will not be the best experience in the game you can have. The best way to enjoy this game is to make the experience your own. That means make the powers your own. Design the character your way. Put the powers on there you want. Don't go with what the game gives you. Think about what you want and use those powers and abilities. Play around with them. Use all of them. Try them out. See which ones you love. See which ones you hate. That's the only way to really have fun with this game. To make it your own. That's the idea. Make it your own. And that's what I'm going to do. So the next video, we're going to spend that time, and I'm going to show you how you can, even at this stage, a Lieutenant 6, build a good character that will start off so that when we do the first mission, and on and on and on, I can build upon that, and it will be awesome. I will also show you how you earn energy credits. Being that I am on a free-to-play account, I have a limit. You will notice you are limited to having 10 million energy credits, so I cannot have any more than 10 million. Now, you are probably thinking, well, I will never reach 10 million. Well, that's not true. You can, and it's easy to do so, and I'm going to show you how. And the first part of that is you'll notice, as I was playing the tutorial, I grabbed everything. Anything that was dropped, I grabbed. If it was a weapon battery, if it was a shield battery, if it was a hypo spray, I don't care if it's a hypo spray, I'm grabbing it. And there's a reason for that, because you can sell these items, and that's how you earn energy credits, starting off at the beginning of the game. I will talk about that in the next video as well. So, that is what to expect. The next video, we're going to dive into customization on this character and this ship. It'll be awesome. We will design a good character and ship to start off the missions. And then the next video after that, we will do the first mission, Stranded in Space. So thank you all for watching this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed that. This so far has been a very strong start on this playthrough. And I cannot wait to get back in here and customize our character. This is my favorite part. This next video, customizing the character and the ship, are my favorite parts of this game. I love it. So please stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching.